Hello, good day everyone. I'm Tebs. Welcome back to this channel. This next repair is an extreme 40-inch LED TV, model MF4000, not turning on but has a standby light indicator. I'll show you how to fix it. If you like electronics or want to learn how to repair TVs and other electronics gadgets, you came to the right channel. So show your support by liking and subscribing. You can also ring the notification bell to keep you updated. So let's get started. The TV is not turning on, so let's measure the voltages. The 12 volt supply is steady at 12.078 volts. This is the dual regulator. The reading is steady at 3.31 volts. And the other output is also steady at 1.81 volts. Let's measure the DC to DC converters. The reading is steady at 5.2 volts. And the other one is also steady at 1.18 volts. Let's measure the EEPROM VCC voltage. The reading is 3.31 volts and it is stable. Looks like all the voltages are normal and stable, and no bloated capacitor that may cause the TV to not turn on. Let's heat up the LCD driver chip, and see if it will going to turn on. Sometimes when heating up the chip it will wake up and the TV will work. When the chip is cold it will sleep and the TV won't turn on again. It means the chip is defective. But in this case it still won't turn on. Maybe the chip is okay. This issue is also a firmware problem. Let's remove the EEPROM and try to reprogram it. This is my homemade EEPROM chip mounting or used to solder the chip and connect it to the USB CH341A programmer. This is what it looks like. The PCB used to solder the EEPROM is damaged now due to many times of soldering and desoldering the EEPROM chip. So I made this PCB to solder the chip. Let's go ahead and solder the chip. The chip is 25xx32, it is a 32-bit serial flash memory. Now the EEPROM chip is soldered properly. Let's insert it into the USB port and reprogram it. The programmer can't detect the chip. Maybe it's defective. So let's get another chip. The EEPROM chip can detect now. Let's erase the chip. Now let's program it with the right firmware. The board is TP.V56.PB801. I get the firmware somewhere on the web. If you want this firmware, just Google it. There are tons of firmware out there. The LCD panel is HD, not full HD because the LVDS data lines are only 5 pairs, so it is a 1366x768 resolution. So let's pick this file. Now let's start the program. The programming is complete. Let's verify it to ensure the file is written correctly. The buffer is the same, which means it was written the file correctly. Now let's remove the EEPROM and solder into the TV main board. For those asking me to use flux, okay, let's put flux. The reason I don't use flux sometimes is that you should clean the disgusting flux that flows everywhere on the board. It is an extra effort for me, and it's a waste of time. The soldering lead have already flux on it, so it is not necessary to add more flux. Use flux if you want the solder only to look good. But this channel shows how to troubleshoot, not to show how to solder. The EEPROM is soldered in place. Let's try if we have power now. The TV have power. But looks like the image is not good. Seems the panel mapping is not right. Let's use a universal remote to access the service mode. We don't know the code, so let's use the search method of the universal remote. Press the set and power at the same time. When the light gets on, then press the volume up continuously. Until the volume appears on the screen, then press set to save the code. Now let's enter service mode. Press the menu, then press 1147, and the service mode should appear. Select the panel setting, and change the value preset panel ID, until you see the image become better. Seems 0 is the right value. Press exit to quit. As you can see, the image now is okay. Let's restart the TV. If you want to remove the logo, enter service mode again, and then select general setting. Select the logo, then turn off. Restart the TV. And the logo now is gone.
A few moments later.
The TV now is working great. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed and learned something from this video. You can help this channel by showing your support by liking and subscribing. You can also ring the notification bell so you never miss a video like this. Once again, this is Tefs. See you again next time. Bye for now.